After I watered your mouth with a quick look at what is possible in Luminar in the first lesson of this series, I will start guiding you step by step through Luminar in this lesson and in the following videos. Plus, we will have the last three licenses of our giveaway at the end of the video. My name is Wolf Amri, wolf.amri on Instagram, and you really should subscribe to this channel. Maybe there will be more photography giveaways in the future. I am a big fan of structured learning and teaching. You cannot learn a software if you just look at a few tutorials and mimic what others do. Only when you understand the software by heart can you use it to its full potential. And that is why I start at the very basics. I usually create a separate Luminar catalog for every project that I do. That will keep things organized and avoid Luminar getting slower in time. I've heard people say that will happen if the catalog gets large. By the way, I do the very same with every other software. So I go to File, Catalog, New, and name it Year, Month, Shooting Description. And then I add a few tags that describe the shooting: dog, family, or whatever fits. Next, I select the location I want to save it to. I'm on a Mac, by the way, so don't be surprised if it looks different on your computer. And hit Save. Luminar will automatically create a folder on your hard drive with the same name as the catalog, which is pretty handy to keep things organized. Now we need to get some images into the catalog. To do that, you have different options. If you want to import images from your SD card, you would have to go to File, Import Images to Folder. But that is grayed out if you start a new catalog. Weirdly, I have to create a folder first over here in the Library tab. I hit the plus icon next to Folders and add a folder within the parent folder of my catalog. I usually call it Raw. Now I can again go to File, Import Images to a Folder. I will select my memory card, and down here I have a few options. I can choose if I want to copy or move the images, or if I want to further organize the folder. I usually choose year, month, day. And I could also choose if I want to include subfolders. That would import all images in any of the subfolders on the card. If you don't want that, you could choose single image files. What you don't get in Luminar is that neat import dialog you get, for example, in Lightroom, where you can better organize images right at import. Back to Luminar, then I hit Import to Folder. Where will the images be imported to? The folder I selected here. So much for importing from an SD card. Let me quickly delete this folder again to show you a different method. If you already have files on your computer, you can also click the plus icon on the top left, and this time select Add Folder with Images. Or you can change to the Library module and press the plus icon beside Folders. Both options import an existing folder on your hard drive into the catalog. An advantage of Luminar versus Lightroom for me is that images are automatically synced. So if I add an image or move it to a different folder, it will automatically be updated in my Luminar catalog. The downside is the edits will be gone if I move the image to a different folder. If you don't want to use Luminar as a catalog, but only for editing similar to Photoshop, you can import a single image. Go to the plus icon on the top left and select Edit Single Image. The image will then be ready to edit and will rest in your single image edits up here. Talking about single edits, you can use Luminar as a plugin within, for example, Lightroom. But you don't want that because Lightroom will then export a TIFF file. So instead of working on the raw file, you're now working on a TIFF. Not clever. Now that I have the images in my catalog, I usually dash through them all to pick the best ones from a particular shooting. I do that in three phases. First, I pick the ones I like best, and at the same time delete the ones that have bad poses, closed eyes, and whatnot. I do that in gallery images mode, but make sure to select largest up here to get a good overview of things. That particularly helps if you, like us, often shoot in burst mode where your cameras take few consecutive images, for example, of people, and want to make sure they have their eyes open in at least one image. Another example would be running dogs. If you have a small monitor, let me recommend getting rid of the sidebar here by clicking on the currently active module, in this case, library. That will give you more room for the images. So I quickly dash through the images and select the ones I like using the P key, P for pick, or flag the ones that I want to delete with an X. If I change my mind and want to unpick or unflag, I press U for unpick. Once I'm done with my first round, Luminar will let me select only the favorites by selecting favorites in this dropdown, or if you have the sidebar visible, just click here. Now I usually still have way too many picks. Plus, from looking at the small previews, I don't know if they are really sharp or not. So I have to take a closer look. To do that, make sure you are in single image mode, and to get a better overview, enable film strip by pressing view, hide show, film strip. That way I can see thumbnails of the remaining images on the left. Luminar is definitely slower than, for example, Lightroom when it comes to loading your images so that you can fully zoom in to see the images are 100% sharp. That's because of the AI algorithm that will later help you speed up your workflow. So doing your first selection in the grid view, as we've done before, helps a lot. By the way, doing your first selection in grid view will also help you in Lightroom. For my second round, I use another built-in rating tool of Luminar, the star rating. The best of the favorites will receive a 5-star rating in this second round. The numeric keys represent a shortcut for that, and me always trying to speed up my workflow, I use them. So 5 is a 5-star rating. In case I find out that an image is out of focus and I want to look at a different one of that series, I quickly change to all photos up here on top, flag the one that is out of focus with an X, and pick a different one. Once I did that, I go to favorites again up here to only display the picked ones. When I'm done giving my 5-star ratings, I want Luminar to only show me the favorites with a 5-star rating. I change to the gallery images mode and tell Luminar to only show me images with a 5-star rating. If I then still have too many images, I use the color label, usually green, which has the shortcut 8, but you can also select another one. To see the shortcuts for these, go to Image, Set Color Label, and the numbers here represent the shortcuts. When I'm done color labeling, I tell Luminar to only show me images with a green color label to display the very best images of a shooting. Talking about selecting your best images, do that and only publish your very best work. This will immediately make you appear a much better photographer. I tell you a secret, the great photographers also have crappy images. They just don't show them to anyone. So everyone thinks they only create top-notch images. By the way, I have gathered that and some other tips to quickly become a better photographer in this video. Okay, back to selecting images. What if we want to organize the images and want the ones with the dog only in the frame? I select them all using the Control key, and here beside Albums, I click the plus icon. That will create an unnamed album that I will now rename to Dog Only. And now it's time to draw the last three licenses of our Luminar giveaway. But even if you don't win, we have a perk for you because we have a discount code in the description of this video. So let's start. Faxa refuses to help today, so we have to find a different solution. I'm gonna put all these names into a cotton bag, shake it, and now the first one, Brian Klingsmith. The second one is Bianca Eames. And the third one is Michelle Quintanilla. Beautiful name. And that's it. See you next time, people.